Imagine you wake up one morning during the summer. You're sweating. The fan is off overhead. Your AC isn't on. You reach to grab your phone and it's fried. You get out of bed to see your neighbors standing outside sweating bullets. You grab your remote and press the on button. Nothing. You then open your front door and get shoulder checked by oncoming neighbors running with empty grocery bags in their hands to the nearest supermarket. What is going on? You see neighbors under their car hoods trying to get them to run again. Boom! Explosions erupt in a city near you. You hear a familiar door creak open. It's another neighbor running into your house and locking you out. Say goodbye to your food and water. Say goodbye to your normal way of life. Were we hit by an EMT? You could say that, but think bigger. Why not take a look up? But just for a couple of seconds. Ah, the sun. Beautiful, isn't it? The literal star of our Milky Way galaxy. Though taken for granted, the sun is the driving force for all life on Earth. But as quickly as the sun brings life, it can end it even faster. While many people know its impending mega-explosion will be the end of every nearby planet in billions of years, most people don't know it could be the death of humanity a lot sooner than that. Enter something called solar flares. These solar explosions are primarily due to the sun's intense internal magnetic field, getting jumbled up and interlaced with each other, to the point where the sun is forced to shoot out deadly solar storms and flares all throughout the solar system. But we're not here to talk science. We're here to talk survival. Now, these flares aren't normally given a second look by the ordinary citizen, since they usually leave little damage like temporary shutting down orbiting satellites and radio communication systems, or endangering astronauts aboard a nearby space station. But the living creatures of Earth remain unharmed due to our savior of an atmosphere absorbing and deflecting the harmful effects of these solar flares. These flares, when rejected, head to our north and south poles, creating beautiful sights like the Northern Lights. But don't let this beauty deceive you. Every other century or so, the sun produces what we call a solar superstorm. But instead of the thunderdogs fear during a regular rainstorm, our sun would instead send a deadly shockwave compressing our magnetic field. Well, if this shockwave's magnetic field and our planet's magnetic field merge in just the right way, the energy may be too much to contain. Usually, the energy goes right over our atmosphere, as previously mentioned, but a storm this size could slingshot back towards us, breaking through our atmosphere. This is called a geomagnetic storm. In our heavily technology-dependent world, this event would shake our planet to the core, literally. A geomagnetic storm could potentially shut down or completely destroy electric grids all across the globe. Remember how unprepared Texas's power grid was due to just inches of snowfall? Think that, but on steroids. Or even the power grid failure in Quebec in 1989. This sudden shutdown of several electrical power grids rocked the city of Quebec and lasted for 12 hours straight, according to NASA. But this wasn't just limited to Canada. The United States also had its share of difficulties, with grids in its northern areas, such as New York and New England, losing plenty of megawatts, but were restored just in enough time to prevent any blackouts. With tensions rising across borders around the world, if one of these events happened again, who knows what wars or conflicts could possibly escalate out of it. Luckily, just like in 1989, our engineers know how to handle these deadly storms, but would they have been ready if we were hit by the incoming superstorm that barely missed us in 2012? Yep, the Mayans were nearly laughing at us all. If you think people hoarding toilet paper during the recent COVID-19 pandemic was scary, imagine being hit by this 2012 superstorm and being stuck 4 to 10 years without power all over the world. But just because we got lucky once doesn't mean it can't happen again. Scientists say the chances of a superstorm colliding with us increases 12% per decade, leading us to a 50-50% chance of one happening in the next 50 years. Scared yet? But we're not done. If these geomagnetic storms sound horrifying, just wait until you hear about superflares. If the sun's magnitude gets even more out of hand, it can produce storms that will erupt even deadlier flares, known as superflares, the biggest brother of all solar flares, as far as we know. Superflares can take place every few thousand years, and even a calm sun like our own can produce superflares more powerful than any storm we've ever witnessed. These superflares would put any geomagnetic storm to shame, and if we were unprepared for a rare storm such as this reaching us, it could be the end of all life as we know it, meaning no electricity, no clean water to drink or bathe in, no hospital care leading to millions dead or without care, empty supermarkets, and little to no agriculture. This catastrophe could take us decades to get the grid working again, thus potentially sending us back to the Stone Age. Neighbors would be raiding your home, your trip to the Bahamas would plummet into the ocean mid-flight, cargo ships would be lost at sea, strangers would attack you at the supermarket for the last can of tuna, and countries would be invaded by foot. It would be a total fight for survival. In fact, our world has actually had a direct encounter with one of these storms before, known as the Carrington Event. Luckily, the Carrington Event was during 1859, so there was very little progression in infrastructure, and the electronics we had were those such as telegraphs. When this flare impacted these emerging electronics, they were documented to have shocked and burned the owners who handled them. Fast forward 162 years later, and there's not a place an electronic device isn't. If offices were catching fire in 1859 due to the mishandled telegraphs, imagine what our homes and megastructure offices lined with wires every square inch would do. Never mind being left in the dark, imagine the millions of fires that would combust all around your city and neighborhood. A flare of the Carrington Event magnitude would devastate our world to the brink of collapse and could soon be on its way in as little as 3 years, some scientists predict. But this apocalyptic wasteland could be prevented. Scientists actually have the ability to see these storms days in advance, and our engineers know how to handle disasters like this, simply by taking our grids offline for a while. Kind of like turning your TV on and off again, only if you don't turn it off, billions could die. No pressure. And due to the fact that these flares happen all over the sun and can be sent anywhere in space, that makes the chances of one hitting our constantly moving planet very slim, but never say never. While you may be breathing a sigh of relief, we do have to ask ourselves questions like, will we be ready? Or even if we will invest in our grid's protection beforehand so we can avoid the disaster fees later. Dangerous rays of energy could be on their way, and we may not even know it until it's too late. While the sun is our best friend now, it may soon resemble something as sinister as the Death Star. And even though our Earth's atmosphere is the real hero in this story, protecting us from previous flares, make sure you thank an engineer the next time you see one, because your life could very well be in their hands if our invisible hero fails.